Good morning, dear student. This is Gauranayab, your maths teacher, and we are discussing direct inverse proportions. And today we are going to discuss exercise 1D. So let's continue. Exercise 1D, question number 1. If x is inversely proportional to y cube and x is 50 when y is 2, find the value of x when y is 4. Find an equation connecting x and y and calculate the value of y when x is 3.2. Since x is inversely proportional to y cube, that means x times y cube is equals to k. Now replace x with 50 and y with 2, so you're going to get the value of k as 400. Now we are going to find the value of x, so we can use this equation, and x will be k, and you're going to take this y cube on the other side as a denominator. It will be x is equals to k upon y cube. So replace k with 400 and y with 4. So cube of 4 is 64, and 400 divided by 64 is 6.25. That's the value of x. Now make a connecting equation with respect to y, because that is what we have to find in the next part. So y will be cube root of x upon k upon x. And why is that? Because you're going to take this x as denominator on the other side, but to remove this cube, we are going to take cube root on the other side. So that's the reason. Replace x with 3.2. Using the same connecting equation, replace x with 3.2. And that means 4 upon 3.2 will give you 125. So 5 times 5 times 5 is 125. So cube root of 125 is 5. Pause the video. And now solve question number 2 by yourself. Once done, please resume the video. Exercise 1D, question number 4. If z is inversely proportional to cube root of x and z is 5 when x is 64, find the value of z when x is 216. Since z is inversely proportional to cube root of x, we can write it as z times cube root of x is equals to k. Replace the value of x with 64 and z with 5. So cube root of 64 is what? Any guesses? It's 4. 4 times 4 times 4 is 64. So cube root of 64 is 4. So k will be 20. Now we are going to make a connecting equation with respect to z, because we have to find z, find the value of z. So z will be what? Z will be x upon cube root of x. Now we are going to use this connecting equation to find the value of z. Okay. Since k is 20 and x is 216, so z will be 20 upon 6, because cube root of 216 is 6. 6 times 6. It's 36. 36 into 6 is 216, which will be 3.33. Once done, please pause the video and solve question number 5, which looks like this only. You can take this sum as a sample and solve question number 5 by yourself. Once done, resume the video. Let's continue. If t is inversely proportional to cube of s, copy and paste the table. There are some things missing here. But what we know is we have got S1 and AT as T. So we are going to use this box because it has got both the values. Now let's come back to the question. T is inversely proportional to S cube. That means T times S cube is K. That is something that we already know. Now use this both boxes. Replace t with 80 and s with 1. So that means we are going to get the value of k as 80. Now, since we have to find both the values here, s and t, that means we will make two connecting equations with respect to s and t. So let's make it. S will be cube root of k upon t. Why is that? Because you're going to take t as denominator on the other side. And to remove this cube, you have to take cube root here. Replace the value of k with 80 from here. And that's it. This will become your connecting equation. Now, make the connecting equation with respect to t. So you're going to take s cube as your denominator on the other side. That does it, because that simply is the connecting equation. Now we are going to solve. If s is 2, how much is t? So use this connecting equation. T is k upon s cube. And now s is 2. So cube of 2 is 8. So 80 upon 8 is 10. So you can write here 10. Now if s is 4, how much is t? Use the same connecting equation. Replace s with 4. Cube of 4 is 64, and 80 upon 64 is 1.25. So write here 1.25. Now if t is 0.08, how much is s? So you're going to use this connecting equation, this thing. So s is k upon t cube root. So cube root of k is 80 and t is 0.08, which will give you 1000. So cube root of 1000 is 10, because 10 times 10 times 10 is 1000. If t is, so you can write here 10. So if t is 0.01, how much is s? Same thing. You're going to use the same connecting equation, but now this time you're going to put t as 0.01. So 80 upon 0.01 is 8000. And so cube root of 8000 is 20. So you can write 20 here. Once done, you can solve part B yourself, because it looks just like this. And I'll see you again in the next class with the remaining questions. If you don't understand anything, kindly rewind this video so that you have a better understanding and better idea. Remember, practice makes perfect. Hope to see you again in the next class.